To me, the black holes are about belief. They're about belief in art, belief in illusion and image, and belief in your own ability to believe something. As you walk around the pieces, they shift and change like a parallax, and the image begins to break down as you reach the sides, where you begin to see the mount, the wiring, and the way that the pieces are constructed. It's similar to when you watch a movie or a play. Do you get fully absorbed in the story, or do you see the rectangle constantly? Do you look backstage to see what the stagehands are doing? And if you are aware of all that, does that even matter to you? The paintings are made of traditional painting materials, but they're configured to create a high relief sculpture. The black section is just plain canvas and paint, and the white section is paneling with black light reactive paint. And in between, there's a mount to hold the canvas on the wall and a bunch of black lights to illuminate the actual panel. Now, because they require multiple components, there are several technical considerations that are fairly involved. The first is the canvas itself. The angles are double beveled, so there's a bit of math that goes into creating the actual stretcher bars themselves. And then when you go to stretch it, the canvas doesn't want to create this elegant curve. It wants to ripple and warp as it sees fit. So it takes some time to actually get the proper stretch. Since the pieces all involve the point of view of whoever's looking at it, the point of view has to be sighted out manually. So the canvas has to be put up, and then the outline of the panel has to be drawn on the wall or masked out with tape on the wall so that it can be constructed from there. Normal fixtures won't actually fit behind the canvases, so everything has to be done from scratch. The lights have to be at the correct angle so that they'll actually illuminate the panel properly, and there has to be enough of them, and they have to fit behind the canvas so that you can't see them from the correct point of view. In a way, for me, the pieces are about a modern sense of religious doubt. When you can see the illusion and see how the illusion was created, and when you can choose what to worship, whether that's art, yourself, or any god that you might pick, what happens to your sense of self? What happens to your sense of spirit when you can just exchange one higher power for another?